it surprisingly took 7 months. I haven't had any hiccups since. You know, they said it was going to take about 8 to 12, so, you know, made it back. We're here.
How much work did you put in to get there?
A lot. I mean, I did rehab probably 5-6 days a week, about 2 hours a day. So, you know, it was all worth it, though. Made it.
Are you amazed at you come in last year as a freshman, you're kind of working your role, you get injured, you fight to come back. But it seems like your role this year is going to be so much more different. I mean, that's a pretty interesting kind of process there. Yeah. How are you handling that?
I think I'm handling it well. You know, all the work I put in to get back, I think that this is definitely a role that I needed to have. And, you know, already having the experience of, you know, playing a little bit last year and also, you know, being in practice with you know, the veteran guys and all that, definitely prepared me a lot for this year, for sure.
Back to normal? I mean, back to doing everything that you did before you were injured?
Yeah, I'm all back. I'm all good.
Well, rehab was a new experience, yeah. I guess. So what was it like? I mean, you know, going through that.
Yeah, it was tough. It was definitely tough. I mean, I couldn't do regular things like run and walk and things like that for the first like 3 months, you know, 3 months, 4 months. So it was really tedious, really a lot of little things that I had to work on, like getting my calf strength back and things like that. So it was definitely tough, but made it happen. So
anything now you do better than you did before you were injured?
I'd probably say shoot, handle the ball.
Which were things you could do?
Yeah, I could do before, but now I really honed in on them. And probably say my IQ is a lot higher, just able to watch college basketball the whole year on the bench, hearing the coaches, you know, say this and that, you know, whether it was a mistake or it was a good thing. So, yeah, that's probably the best thing I got.
So how'd you get those physical things better? Because you couldn't practice much. So how did you work on shooting, ball handling, those things?
You know, we'd be on road trips or just me doing rehab in general. There'd be a lot of times I'd be on the court just shooting. And a lot of times I couldn't jump, you know, on my jump shot. Or I couldn't run or do any pull-ups. So I would just sit there shooting threes, standing still. You know, all that, and my range increase and all that, and really worked on my touch. And then ball handle, obviously, just stationary things. Then obviously IQ, I would stand on the top and work on passes and passing from different areas and things like that. So that's really how I got it right.
Do you all feel like the unknown guy on this team in the sense that, you know, I imagine there's probably a lot of anticipation, and you say, hey, they don't know what I can do. I'm going to show them what I can do.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I think I was starting to come along really well towards the end of the year or towards the end of when I got hurt. And then I don't think a lot of people got to see as much as I could have shown due to play time and things like that and just trying to get used to college basketball. But I'm definitely excited for this year to show what I can do and things like that.
Is there like a key thing that you want to be able to show, put out there, whether it's shooting or athleticism?
Yeah, just all around. I mean, trying to show that I'm a mismatch, you know, and I can play really anywhere on the floor. So that's really what it is.
Hugs has mentioned 4 out, maybe even 5 out with you on the floor. Mm-hmm. Does that fit what you guys do?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, this year, you know, in practice, I'm noticing a lot where we have a lot of mobile bigs, you know, so we can, you know, everybody can really stretch the floor, especially when I'm in the game, you know, me, JB, you know, Gabe, you know, we can all play outside and make things happen. So I think it's going to be a really big thing that we do this year.
What went through your mind? Oh, I'm sorry, go ahead, Mike.
Kind of going off what you're saying, that people didn't get to see a whole lot of you in your all-around game. I think a lot of people further up really just knew that you're a shooter, which is kind of odd because you're so tall.
Yeah.
But Gabe and Taz and some other guys said that your inside play kind of stood out too, post up, dunking, driving to the basket, finishing there too. That exists, I guess, but one of the things we haven't seen or assumed that exists. But what can you tell me about that you were good at and you are better at now?
I was always good inside. I think it's just the way I naturally play is more, you know, outside or finding the open space and trying to make plays from there. But, I mean, I can pretty much do anything on the floor, you know, any spot that I'm at. But I've definitely been trying to get a lot better in the post, just strength-wise and making big plays down there. So
Isaiah, what went through your mind when you got hurt, when they told you you were going to miss the year? I mean, mentally that's got to be difficult. What went through your head?
Yeah. It just the uncertainty, you know, of coming back and, you know, if I'm ever going to be the same or if I'm ever, you know, I don't know if I'm ever going to, you know what I mean, play again, things like that. So, but, you know, as rehab went through and things like that, I started getting a lot better and started, you know, my mind started getting better. So, it's good.
How do you think of yourself? Do you think of yourself as a big guy who can do things that little guys can do?
Nah, I was never a little guy. But I think I'm just a big guy that can do a lot of things on the floor.
So. The fact that your game, I mean, somebody technically has to be the five out there.
Yeah.
And Derek did what he did last year as five.
Sure.
But the fact that your game is so much different than what his game was, does that help you in mentally, like, you know, I don't have to go out and do it. Because my game is different, and we're doing things different. I mean, does that kind of help you in your transition and becoming a five? But even if it's a different kind of five than what Derek was.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you know, they're letting me play the way I play. You know, they're not trying to have me be anybody else or be anything that I'm not. So that definitely helps me a lot. You know, they're giving me the confidence to just be myself out there and, you know, do things that help benefit the team. So.
Probably a big weight off your shoulders.
Yeah, for sure. No doubt.
We've asked everybody who's going to grab Derek's rebounds, but I'm guessing it's going to be a collaborative deal. You don't feel like you have to do it, do you?
Yeah, I mean, I hope I don't have to.
Get 10 a game?
I'm going to try. I'm going to get there. Try for sure.
But along those lines, a lot of the guys said, well, you know, there were times they felt like they were guilty of just standing there and watching Derek go rebound.
Yeah.
Because Derek was going to get it.
Mm-hmm.
Is it going to have to be more of a collaborative effort this year, you think?
Yeah, we've been working a lot on rebounding, and we're doing a lot of team rebounding. You know, they expect the guards to go in there and get rebounds this year and all that, so we're definitely going to make that happen.
Sure. Isaiah, thank you.
All right, thank you, guys.